pretty sketchy things we just ignore about Meghan Markle. Before we start, I would want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to our channel. In this video, we're gonna see about the things that we just ignore about Meghan Markle. Number one, going to Hollywood. Meghan Markle has had an astonishing life. All things considered, she's gone from TV star to sovereignty surprisingly fast. In any case, a few subtleties aren't exactly just about as mystical as they may appear. Here's a gander at the obscure side of Meghan Markle. In December 2017, news broke Meghan Markle's irritated stepsister Samantha Markle was outfitted to deliver a tell-all book zeroed in on spilling some of the record pieces of information. In a meeting with the Sun, Samantha uncovered, "Meghan's a social climber. Hollywood has changed her. I think she aspires to turn into a princess. The illustrious family would be dismayed by how she's dealt with her own family." Samantha likewise griped at Meghan, everything except overlooked her in the wake of acquiring high society status. Notwithstanding, as per E! News, an individual near the family says Samantha can't be trusted. Number 2. Meghan Markle's related to Prince Harry. That's right, you heard that right, these two lovebirds come from a similar genealogical record. We should think about this while considering other factors because, all things considered, we likely all offer a couple of qualities to a great extent if we follow our lineage back far enough. Although Meghan Markle has conceived American and Prince Harry's British, in October 2017, the Daily Mail performed what they called a genealogical examination, uncovering that the two are purportedly cousins tracking back to the 15th century. The association is on Markle's dad's side, yet it's 15 ages back, so there's no compelling reason to stress over family suppers getting more off-skelter over special times of the year. Number 3. Meghan Markle's secret royal fascination. In their BBC commitment talk with Meghan Markle and Prince Harry uncovered, they'd met in a pre-arranged meeting. "Since I'm from the States, you don't grow up with a similar comprehension of the illustrious family," Markle said. "Thus, while I presently see there's a worldwide interest there, I don't think a lot about him." However, previous companion Ninaki Pretty's Daily Mail Meet recounted an alternate story. "I realized the royal family was something she found intriguing," said Pretty. She had one of Princess Diana's books on her shelf, plus between Princess Diana's prevalence and Prince Harry's days as prime newspaper feed, recollecting the time she went wild in Vegas, it's difficult to accept she knew nothing about the sovereign. Number 4. Puppy trouble. In her Daily Mail talk with previous companion Ninaki Pretty, asserted canine-adoring Meghan Markle paraded her status as an approach to embrace a canine. Presently, the proprietor of two salvages, Markle appears to have a rough relationship with the two of them. In November 2017, a Kensington Palace representative broke the news that Markle's retriever Bogart would not join her abroad. "It's anything but a cause for a creature to traverse the Atlantic, joined with a hard, long interaction of getting the endorsement," said the representative. "It's to the greatest advantage of the creature's prosperity to remain. Instead of going with Markle, Bogart will remain with one of her companions in the United States." That December, the Daily Mail revealed that Markle's other canine, Guy, broke two legs. Conditions encompassing the injury are obscure, however, sources guaranteed Markle was troubled over the mishap. Number 5. Meghan Markle threw a tantrum over an emerald tiara. Most ladies would be overjoyed at the prospect of strolling down the walkway wearing a jewel and platinum bandeau crown handpicked by the sovereign herself. Yet, as indicated by imperial informants, Meghan Markle needed to pick her own. Family insiders with connections to Dan Wooten, leader manager of The Sun, report that Prince Harry's lady of the hour to be clarified which headpiece she needed to wear on her huge day, and things got a little tense when her thought was killed. Meghan had her heart set on this headdress with emeralds, and Prince Harry hit the rooftop when they were advised it was unthinkable for her to wear it. One source asserted the provenance of the headband couldn't be set up. There were concerns it might have come from Russia initially. At the point when information on Markle's purported troublesome conduct arrived at the sovereign, Her Highness chose to give her grandson a decent verbal railing. There was an exceptionally warm tray that incited the Queen to address Harry, Wooten's imperial insider dished. She said, "Meghan can't have anything she desires. She gets what crown she's given by me." The message from the Queen was that Meghan expected to consider how she addresses staff individuals and be mindful to follow family conventions. According to the source, the sovereign struck a dirty move during the trade, addressing why Markle expected to wear customary wedding cover given it was her subsequent marriage. Oof. This brings us to the end of our video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you on the next video.